I'm Ben Bullen.
And I'm Jonathan Strickland.
And today's question is, how do shark senses work?
Underwater. See ya.
But wait, come on, man. What are you doing?
Gonna be more specific?
Yeah.
All right, fine.
So one of the main reasons sharks are such effective predators is their keenly attuned senses.
Yeah, it's not just the nose, right? I mean, they actually have several acute senses, but these must all work together to make a shark a decent hunter.
I like the nose though, John. Let's start with the nose.
All right.
As the shark moves, water flows through two forward-facing nostrils positioned along the sides of the snout. The water enters the nasal passage, moves past folds of skin covered with sensory cells.
Right. Now, in some sharks, these sensitive cells can detect even the slightest traces of blood in the water. So a great white shark, for example, would be able to detect a single drop of blood in, an Olympic-sized swimming pool. Though you don't normally find great whites in Olympic-sized swimming pools.
It's a creepy metric to use.
It is, yeah.
Most sharks can detect blood and animal odors from miles up.
Or kilometers, 1.6 kilometers to a mile.
And a shark's sense of smell is also unique in that it's directional.
What, say what?
Right, okay, so like twin nasal cavities, right? The way that you have two ears.
Yeah.
The smell would be coming from the left of the shark. It'll arrive in that left nasal cavity before it hits the right one. So in this way, a shark can figure out where a smell is coming from.
You know, sharks also have a very acute sense of hearing. Mm. Research suggests they can hear low-pitched sounds well below the range of human hearing. Now, sharks may track sounds over many kilometers or...
miles.
For distress, you know, they're listening for distress sounds from wounded prey.
Help me, I'm dying, I can't swim, I'm bleeding a lot.
Yeah, that would be exactly what they're listening for. What about eyesight?
Oh, eyesight's a really good one because eyesight varies from shark to shark, or at least species to species. So some of the less active sharks that stay near the water's surface, they don't have particularly acute eyesight. Mm. However, sharks that stay at the bottom of the ocean...
Now, these sharks have evolved to have very large eyes that let them see in near total darkness. Now, most all sharks have a pretty wide field of view because their eyes are positioned on each side of their head. Cut that out.
Okay.
Right. But they also rely on their sense of taste, right?
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Because sharks are kind of picky, actually. They'll give something a test bite before they fully commit to eating it.
It reminds me of something that happened between me and Josh Clark just 5 minutes ago.
Anyway, these sensitive taste buds are clustered in the mouth. They analyze the potential meal to see if it's palatable.
Right, they'll often reject prey that is outside their ordinary diet. So a human being, not normally on a shark's diet. So sometimes they just reject it immediately. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, a tire.
Yeah.
A license plate.
A car.
Right,
like
yeah.
A
these
whole
sort
car.
Of things, sharks don't usually put that on the menu. But they also possess some senses we don't fully understand, right?
Yeah, like the Ampullae of Lorenzini.
Oh man, I loved him in that one Italian zombie flick. That was intense.
It's an organ that gives sharks the ability to do something called electroreception.
I was totally thinking of something else.
The ampullae consist of small clusters of electrically sensitive receptor cells positioned under the skin in the shark's head.
Right, they're connected to pores on the skin's surface via small jelly-filled tubes. Now, we don't fully understand everything about these ampullary organs, but we know that the sensors allow sharks to see weak electrical fields generated by living organisms. So the range of electrosense seems to be, you know, fairly limited.
But I say it still counts as a superpower.
Oh, fair enough, fair enough. I'll allow it.
Then we'll continue to another unique sense organ, the shark's lateral line.
Right, it's basically a set of tubes just under the shark's skin. So you've got these two main tubes running on both sides of the body from the head all the way down to the tail. Water flows through these main tubes through pores on the skin's surface. Now, the inside of the main tubes are lined with hair-like protrusions, which are connected to sensory cells.
When something comes near the shark, the water running through the lateral line moves back and forth. This stimulates the sensory cells, alerting the shark to any potential prey or predators in the area.
So the combination of all of these senses we've talked about make a shark an incomparable predator. So the success of sharks is due largely to those physiological advancements which have kind of happened over the course of millions of years to create an eating machine. His eyes are like a doll's eyes. When it bites, they roll back.
That's it. Sharks are superbly built to find food. It's their senses working in unison. That Jaws excerpt was for free.
yes, let me tell you about the time I was on the Indianapolis. That's actually for later. In the meantime,
yes.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure you like it and subscribe to the channel. We've got a lot more information coming your way, not just about sharks, about other stuff.
In fact,
we have the big board over there. And
that one's good.
Yeah, that one's good.
These are all actually.
Yeah, man,
I like
Robert
all of these.
Called that one.
Oh. Yeah.